Hi, I'm Rich here at New Life Scientific, and today I'm actually in the back of the building, and the reason for that is because our high voltage connection is on the back end of the building where we do our cleaning. So I wanted to set up and do a video of this. This is actually a high voltage machine. This is an Emulsiflex. It's a D20B, and it's actually made by Evestine from up in Canada. And they're very well known to build very quality machines. We've actually had one in the past. It was a little smaller than this one, not near the capacity. But this one's actually a 20 liter per hour capacity. And it's also a 30,000 PSI machine. So this is very comparable to microfluidics, microfluidizer homogenizing. I'm gonna point out a couple of the features on this one. It actually comes with two gauges. It has a manual, kind of the manual pressure gauge here that you'll see running too. And then it also has another one up here, and that's what this is here. So it's actually catching the pressure again, feeding it up to a digital meter. And the reason this meter is on here, because if it would happen to go over 30,000 PSI, and I think it's set at 31,000 PSI, it'll actually shut the machine down so it doesn't damage anything. So that's kind of a nice option to have on there. And it actually does some other things on it too, but that's the main purpose of it. And then also this machine has another option. It's called a flush system that is able to flush the system out. And that's what this hose does here. It can actually flush fluids through, and it hooks in the back, and then it just kind of cleans out both pumping heads on the both sides. So wanted to demonstrate it running. I went ahead and already primed it. And what I like to do when I'm priming these units is I have a big syringe that I use, and I just suck up some of the fluids that I'm going to be running through it. And then I just stick it down in here and force it. And then while I turn this on, and so we're going to get ready to start it here in a bit. While I'm turning it on, I actually just put some pressure through the syringe to help just force the air out. And it speeds up the priming so much faster. And then I just have this little converter cup here that goes from a 1-inch to a 2-inch. And I get that filled up and ready to go. And then it's all kind of set, ready to put my main 2-liter reservoir on there. But I've actually added this adapter. And then I've got this big 2-liter that we're gonna set on top here. And we're gonna just dump water in it. So I've flushed this out quite a bit with alcohol and water already. I always do that when we get units in to get any kind of residue out. But it's very easy to get up and running, and I've got it kind of on a tall table too, so the reservoir's kind of up high. But right now it's just set up. I'm just going to pump it down into a waste jug down here. So I've got actually 2 liters filled in this, and I'm just going to dump all 2 liters in. And I've already actually timed this unit to verify that it does 20 liters per hour. And I actually ran just 2 liters through it, like I'm doing now. And it was right on the 6-minute mark, which identifies actually 20 liters an hour. So now it's primed. I've got, my fluids in it, which is this water. At this point, my e-stop is off, so I'm just ready to hit the start button, and it's just gonna start up. But I like to set the pressures. Right now it's set at 40 PSI, because this is what actually regulates the actual pressure of the pump. So it has a special design that Evestine has put into it. So I'm gonna turn this down, because I don't wanna throw it start up super high pressure, and we're just gonna work that up as we start it. So we're gonna go ahead and hit the start button. And the motor's spinning up. You can see it's primed. And both cylinders are definitely firing, because if there was air in one cylinder, we would get half the pressure that it's producing right now. So, and we can see down here, we've got a nice flow coming out. And at this point, we can start cranking up the air regulator. And that's what And I'm actually gonna just throw it into an overload, And as I'm turning it up, you can also watch up here, because this 12 is actually 12 times 1,000, which is 12,000. So as I turn the air regulator up, that's what raises the pressure. So we're running about 15,000 PSI there, and I'll crank it up a little more, 16,000. And I'm just gonna keep running it up, and I'm gonna show you what happens when it goes over 30,000, so you can see what happens and what the reasoning behind the reset meter is, and I'll also show you how to reset it. But you can see we're running up past 22, 23, 24, 25, and I'm just cranking it up. We're about at 45 psi on the air pressure. So we're gonna hit that limit switch and it's gonna shut the machine down. 31,000, shut it down. And that's what it's for. So you say, well, okay, I did that. Well, it's pretty easy to start back up. So we're just gonna lower the regulator pressure back down again to make sure it don't start back up and throw us into another kill. On the side here is your reset switches over here. Now if we can get a shot of this. So you also have a data out here and you have a zero and a reset. So all I'm gonna do is hit the reset and get rid of our 31,000 and get it back down to where it needs to be. And then sometimes I have to actually hit the reset twice, or there's possibly a time allowance in there, but it allows us to start the machine up again. And again, we're back down to the safer zone because I turned the pressure down. So this is a little bit different than the microfluidics unit, where it actually uses a hydraulic system in it and it uses hydraulic rams to move the plunger. I like this because it has a flywheel assembly in it and it has two rams instead of one. So it's moving back and forth. So you got two pressure heads, it's equally dividing in, coming back up, and then it running through our reaction chamber here. So, and it's just pressing it down through and coming out here. So everything is working great on this thing. It's one of the nicest machines I've seen. It gives you that higher production need that you need if you need to run a little more production. And it's not too terrible noisy depending on how much pressure you need to run. But I really like the safety option. And you can really just dial in. But anyways, a couple more minutes and it's gonna be burned through that water. And I don't think we need to wait for that, because you can see it's running perfectly fine. I can turn this all the way down and process it where you can barely hear it. It definitely slows us down a little bit, but not too much. But this is really warm here too, as that's coming through that reaction chamber. It's just building a lot of heat up, which shows us, that it is definitely homogenizing through the pressures. So anyways, if you've got any questions on this machine, it's a really nice company that we've dealt with before, and I love their product. And I think that's about it for this one. So like I said, I'm Rich at New Life Scientific, and if you got any questions, give us a call. Thanks for watching.